Hey, what's good? Sorry for my bad voice here, and I might sniffle a little bit. So I'm a little bit sick, but in this video, we're going to talk about communism as a form of collectivism versus running your own business and having people run their own businesses as a form of collectivism. And I'm in California, so this is a lot of people are into politics and whatnot. So this is like a kind of interesting topic, and yeah, we'll just get into it. So in America today, we have an issue, or somewhat of an issue. People want to help their fellow countrymen, but half of the people want to do it in like a communistic form, while the other half of people, they want to run their own businesses, patronize other people's businesses and help the community that way, as opposed to like a communist kind of we all pay in and then like, you know, the top kind of, or well, not necessarily Marxism but communism. It's not like necessarily a workers kind of unite thing. It's more of we give money to the government. It's like a government communism. Give money to the government and they distribute it. So kids have grown up to adulthood witnessing one form or the other, and I'm in California, so even though I'm in like a red place in California, in terms of like our media and what we kind of been exposed to, we kind of witness the more communistic form, but obviously this is not the case in other parts of the country. But now these kids are growing up to be young adults like myself. And it's clear that they're kind of confused, myself included. If you just look at social media, you can kind of see it. And if you're talking to your friends, you can kind of see it depending on your age. And in reality, these are two sides of the same coin, really. Running your own businesses and the communism part. Some of the kids are going to end up starting their own businesses. And then most of them are going to end up working for those businesses. And that's, they're both helping out the community in that sense. So it's not necessarily like the same goal is essentially achieved by the end of it. It's just kind of the way you go about that goal. But what we can't do is punish one side or the other. And I see that happening in California a little bit, mostly because of the way, like kind of the how taxes work, and just how like the level of competition when it comes to like it's just hard to kind of start your own thing. If that makes sense. Like you're not really competing against the other people who are trying to start their own thing. Like you're kind of competing against like just certain regulations more so. Like certain things you have to do before you can get started. And like that's, some of that is due to inflation, but I want to get into that. But okay, like I'm in California. And most people here vote red. Like, so most people here are red in terms of like their political party, like they're Republican. I don't really like to get into like politics that much, but yeah, I guess just in terms of where they vote, they're Republican. But in this city, there's a lot more like just Democrats in this city, because like a lot in the city, people go into the city to work. Most people don't go into the city to start a business. They go into the city to work. And a lot of times the people in the cities, they vote for politicians who at the top, like Gavin Newsom, for example, who kind of punish, not necessarily on purpose, because I don't really know him personally, so I can't say that, but they kind of punish the owners, like the people who are trying to like own their own thing. Just with the policies, like for example, COVID lockdowns, isn't helping, like, people. Like, if you go through my town, there's a lot of people that closed up. So that's not helping. Yeah, and we'll just leave that there. But ultimately, the United States... this is just me talking now. The United States was founded, at least the idea was founded on separate entities taking care of their community and not necessarily top-down control. So kind of, you know, taxation without representation, give me liberty or give me death, etc. Like, those are the things that the founding fathers discussed when breaking from Britain in the first place. So it's clear that they weren't too enamored with the top-down control that they perceived was happening of the states by the British across the Atlantic Ocean. Like, across the ocean, basically. So they tried to get away from that kind of top-down form of governing. And they wanted the states to basically be control their local area, and then come together, united with certain ideals, but not necessarily in terms of united among the way they all ruled over the people in the state, if that makes sense, or govern the people in the state. Ruled over kind of sounds like, you know, the British crown or something. So I won't say that necessarily, but yeah, we're kind of going back to now. It's not necessarily the British crown, but it seems like kind of half the people in the country want a bigger centralized power that everyone answers to. Like, for example, if you're like a doctor working for Kaiser, or like a nurse working for like Sutter or something, like, you'll have to send your COVID numbers to the state, which isn't a bad thing necessarily, but often, like, and I was training to be a pharmacist, and a lot of things we would, even if we were hired by a private company that was like listed on the stock exchange and all that, we would gather data and send it to the state, like, at the end of like certain periods, like at the end of the day, end of the week, end of the month, etc. We'd have to send certain data from the patients and of the drugs to the state, which ultimately was sent to the central power, like the central federal government. And I don't want to, like, some things that's very necessary, but yeah, that's kind of a form of top-down control. Yeah, and I'll just leave it there, because I'm pretty young, so I don't know exactly, like, I don't want to speak too much, but that's just an interesting thing I'm realizing as I start working. And, like, finding work that kind of suits me. Yeah. And I'll just, like, leave that there for this video. Up next, maybe more MGTOW videos or something, because I got some impressions on my last one. And like I said, I don't love all these terms, but that just happens to be the way, like, people are talking, so. I kind of like the concepts behind the words better. And that's what you'll hear me talking about more. But, yep, that's it. Stay healthy. Enjoy this December. Peace out.
It is what it is. That's what.